Hey everybody, so today we're going to be talking about the Dota Major Championships, and I think this will be the last big TI, and then you'll start to see the separate events, kind of like how CSGO has it. So you get one company holding an event in the fall. I think DAC will be the winter event, and in spring they'll probably have I think DreamHack and the ESL fight over it. But otherwise, I think you're going to start seeing Valve hold the summer part of the tournament. So that'll be the final TI. So summer will be the TI, and then the other ones are just going to be DAC level tournaments. So if you saw how DAC was and how hyped that shit was, then you probably will like the fall and spring events. Since one of them is American and the other one has to be European or CIS region. The other thing is, I think they wanted to lock down the rosters at some point, because you see a lot of people switch teams and it creates for a lot of issues when people want to play fantasy and all that. I mean, that's just a betting man's opinion on it, but a lot of people start to get attached to the players on the roster. So obviously if they go to another team, then it kind of looks really bad if one player starts to switch teams every 3 or 4 weeks. The other thing is, I think 6.84 stuff should be coming out soon. But yeah, so after this TI, we're probably going to start seeing the details about who is going to be running each event leading up to the summer event. And how I think it works in CSGO is each company will submit a proposal depending on what region they decide to hold. Let's say if the fall event is in America, so every company in America is going, well, ones that hold tournaments are going to submit a proposal to Valve, and then they decide who gets the major, which is huge for the company that gets it. So yeah, some of us have been talking about this for a while, where you have, instead of one TI, you have different events, just because you have one event that's $10 million, but then the event before that is, well, only 100,000 apparently, and it just doesn't seem fair that one tournament drowns out all the others. So I think it's better this way, and a lot of people like it this way. So there's kind of like my small take on it. So thank you guys for watching. I'll see you tomorrow, and I think a Borderlands video should be coming up if you're a Borderlands guy that switched to Dota 2 and is watching this. So thanks a lot, peace out.